Hello, my name's Tom Wright.
And I'm Barbara Lockhart.
And we're excited to have you here today for the show called GAGA for Healthy Living. It's a brand new show here on Channel 20 on Fridays, and we're just grateful to be here, right?
It's wonderful to have a television show together.
And so we have a lot of great things planned for today and in the future. And some of the guests we have on today, we have Mike and Holly Semanoff, amazing individuals. I think you guys will really like them. They're both a fitness couple in Pasadena, California. They both got first place and on a competition they recently did in Idaho, they also won first place, each in their own category.
Well, and they were so fun to interview. And the bodies, wow.
You guys will get to see their bodies. But not too provocative, but at least you get to see how fit they are. We also have Karen Grant. Do you want to talk about Karen a little bit?
Well, Karen, I just met her last week, and it was just wonderful to meet her. She's filled with the spirit of love and joy and just wants to do all she can to help people to get over depression and various problems, and she's a wonderful woman.
Now, she's a licensed massage therapist. She's also created her own line of oils. And she's actually a singer also, and so she's created her own CDs for every oil that she has. So it's pretty cool. I mean, she has like hundreds of oils and hundreds of songs that she's done. So.
And we'll get to hear her sing.
We will. We're actually going to tape her on that later today.
Good. Haven't heard her sing yet.
Oh, I have. She's got a beautiful voice. And then our third guest is Blanca Williams. She's a good friend of mine. I've known her husband for years, but she's probably the healthiest person that I know. And so she's going to be on today. We've taped a segment with her. So anyway, we have some exciting things planned. Do you have a comment or a question?
How did you come up with GAGA?
Okay, GAGA.
What is it?
Everybody says, what is that? What's that mean? And GAGA represents Global Awareness for Greater Achievement. And basically what we're trying to do is teach people how to live healthier lives, body, mind, and spirit. And Dr. Lockhart here, she's been my inspiration. I graduated from Brigham Young University in 92 in physical education. And she was one of my undergrad professors. And then I went to graduate school in physical education. And she was one of my graduate professors, but she was like my favorite professor. So anyway, I'm excited to, you know, a little over 10 years later to be on a show with her, so.
Well, and it's so fun for me to see what you've done with the ideas and making a business of these ideas and helping people. That's really exciting.
One of our main objectives with the show is to teach people correct principles of healthy living. Dr. Lockhart and I have actually written a book together. It's called GAGA for Healthy Living. And you can kind of see the same cover here on the backdrop, and that's the name of our TV show. But this book, it's taken a long time to write. Spent about, two or three years working on it since I sent you the first manuscript.
Just in the writing.
Yeah. But it's like, you know, it needs to be backed up by solid research, and, you know, we feel like we've done a pretty good job with it. The best job that I could do with it. You know, it can always get better. The main thing we're trying to do here is affect people's lives for the better. And there's a well-known person, Boyd K. Packer, that said, you know, basically the best way that you can affect people's lives for the better is to teach them correct principles. And I think a lot of times in today's world, you know, there's so many different things going on out there. It's like everybody's, you know, a lot of it revolves around money. They're trying to make money off certain things and a quick fix and things that don't really work long term. But I think if you teach people correct principles, you know, basically teach them truth and they apply that truth, that, you know, it really will make an impact that not only works for the short term, but it works for the long term.
And particularly in this industry, if you will, in fitness and wellness, because there's so many gimmicks and so many shortcuts. And just what you're saying, if we can teach the true principles and then live our lives by those. What we believe makes such a difference, I think more so than people recognize. And there's even a difference between a belief and a value. Most people believe that you have to be active to be fit. You have to exercise. You have to live an active lifestyle. And so they believe that in their hearts. But do they value it? And a value is something you believe in so strongly that you act on it. And so our hope with this program and all that we do in our teaching is to help people value healthy living, to believe in it so much that you actually do it.
One of the things that we've created here, and I've been working on this company for, I don't know, 5 or 7 years now, but we've created a website. It's called gotgaga.com. I don't know if we can get that up on the screen. Yeah, it's up on the screen. But basically, we've gone through, we have a fitness site where we have personal trainers that actually work with people online and over the phone and live in person. We have a nutrition site where we sell nutritionals, things that you can, you know, for supplements and just, you know, overall full spectrum supplements and then targeted nutritionals. We have coaches, we have registered dietitians. I think it's really important to kind of get experts to work with people in certain areas, because a lot of times personal trainers, you know, are counseling people on fitness, which sometimes they are qualified and sometimes they aren't qualified to do, but then they start getting into the nutrition realm, which they really aren't that qualified.
And don't you have recipes and ideas?
We do. We have like 90,000 recipes on our website. We have about $2 million worth of technology on our website. So
wow.
Just our online magazine alone was $1.7 million. And we didn't come up with that. We're basically contracting with another company, but, you know, it's a really
wonderful
it's
resource.
A great website.
Now, you've been active all your life, haven't you? Haven't you just loved to be active?
I have. My mom, when I was a little boy, it's like, you know, the parents give you books and stuff. She said I'd always go to the ones about the body.
Interesting.
I think I've always been just fascinated with, you know, health and fitness and nutrition and, you know, with being in athletics my whole life. And I mean, it's my passion. It's my love.
What I loved is when you were still in graduate school, you were seeking to be on a Major League Baseball team, and you landed on the Yankees of all the teams. Tell us about that.
Well, we got to talk about you, too.
Okay.
No, I played for the Yankees. I went to spring training in 1995 with the Yankees. I started playing professionally. I was first signed in 1989. Kind of played on and off. It was tough because I felt like I had the ability to do some, you know, great things like you did.
And it wasn't that you were 18 or 20 years old.
Yeah, I was 27 when I started.
Okay.
So, you know, I played on and off from the time I was 27 to about 40. So, I don't know. It was a frustrating career, but it's like, you know, just being there on the field where the great players had played. I mean, it's just, it was a dream for me. I just wish I could have continued that dream a little longer.
But you stay active.
I stay active.
And do you compete in bodybuilding, or you just do
it
yourself?
No, I don't do bodybuilding. I do powerlifting. I was top 10 in the nation a few years ago in powerlifting. But that's one of the things I want to do, is I want to try to keep my body strong, you know, because it's like I feel like I'm 46, and it's like I can do what I could do more than I could do when I was 25. And it's a great feeling. It's like I feel like I'm, you know, I'm 46 in mind, but I'm like 25 or 30 in
body.
Now let's talk about you.
Well,
it's like, you
all
know.
The research says that as you age, you lose capacity, but I haven't found that either. When I was 17, I qualified for the Olympic Games in speed skating and competed when I was 18 on through almost 30, so all through my 20s. And my pulse rate at the height of my training was about 40 beats a minute. Now it's runs 52, 53. It hasn't increased that much.
That's awesome.
And I didn't have much upper body strength, but I could bench press about 100 pounds. And I can still do that today.
Hey, we're gonna give you that chance.
Right here on the set.
No, we're working on getting a kitchen together and some fitness equipment together. We're working with some sponsors for the show. So we're gonna do these segments with Mike and Holly and with Blanca, and actually get on there, and we might even jump in and do a little bit. But I don't know if you want to tell people how old you are. It's like, I know it's not right to ask women their age, but you're an example. I mean, it's amazing what you can do.
It's pretty funny. A dear friend says, a woman who will tell her age will tell anything. I used to tell my age all the time, and once she said that, I've been a little cautious. But I could tell you this. I'm a senior citizen. And that's typically between 55 and 65, somewhere in that range. And I fit about every aspect of that. Does that give you a clue? And if you were to ask me next year, I'd have to give you a little different answer.
Okay, for you that are smart enough out there, you should be able to figure that one out. So anyway, we're excited to have her on. She's being pretty modest. She actually was on, was it 3,000 meter? Was it the 3,000 meter?
Oh, in 64?
Uh-huh. Yeah, in 1964 in her second Olympic Games, she was on the last lap. How many laps is it?
It's almost eight.
Eight laps. She was on her seventh lap, and she was on world record and gold medal performance pace. She was ahead of gold, ahead of world record pace, and she was in first place, and then she fell down on her last lap. Can you tell us what that's like to be in the Olympic Games and then go through that?
Oh, it was thrilling. I love the feeling of being fit and your muscles in toned, and I just love that feeling. It's a joyful feeling. And to be in the Games, of course, was the epitome. And people say, well, oh, you fell down, all that for nothing. And I think, how could they think that way? I traveled all over the world, met people from all over the world, had this wonderful body and spirit together. It's just a wonderful feeling, and to have that opportunity was thrilling. So no, that wasn't a huge disappointment. The more joy was just being able to take part and having that opportunity.
Well, I have a hard time watching sports because it's like I always want to be playing, but one of the things I can watch are the Olympic Games because I know a lot of the sports I haven't grown up with, so I know that I don't really have the ability to be out there. So, I mean, I love watching the Olympic Games. That's one of the things that I'm glued to, like every winter and every summer Olympic Games.
Well, I'm excited about this show, Tom. It's going to be so fun to do together.
It is. It's going to be great. We're going to have some awesome guests. I just talked to Thurl Bailey last night, and he said he'd love to come on the show.
And I have some good friends and very competent medical people that want to come on.
Yeah. So we're going to put a great show together for you. We're excited to be here, and we're excited to have you. It's like we want to do this show for you guys, you know, because we feel like we can really help you to be more healthy. And that's the goal of the show, is to teach you those correct principles, to bring guests on and our regular guests and have them teach you things that are really going to impact your life, not just for the short term, but also for the long term.
Now, who do we have first?
Today?
Mm-hmm.
We
Is
have
it Mike and Holly.
Yeah, Mike and Holly Semanoff. They're okay. Our fitness people. So, we're when you guys see these guys, it's like you won't see them that much in these chairs. But when we get them up in front demonstrating the exercises, you'll be able to see how fit they are. And the thing I like about them is they're drug free. So, anyway, we will be right back, and we appreciate your time, and we'll talk to you soon. Welcome to our fitness segment, and we're excited to welcome our regular guests on our show for our fitness segment. It's Holly and Mike Semanoff. And Mike, maybe you can just start by telling us a little bit about, you're on the front cover of our book, Dr. Lockhart and our book, and also on the front cover of our backdrop. So can you tell us a little bit about those pictures?
Well, this top picture is Holly doing yoga at Lake Powell. We go there every year with our family. And
so who took that?
Well, I took it. I was sitting on the bow of a boat, and we set her up on a rock that was close to the surface. And
looks like she's walking on water.
Yeah, she's perfect. She walks on water.
Yeah.
But yeah, the lighting was great, and just was a great shot.
You must be quite a photographer.
He is. He's a brag on himself.
Is that a hobby?
Yeah, it's just kind of a serious hobby. I usually do extreme sports photography. Uh-huh. I skydive with helmet cameras on, and I take big pictures of people doing their first skydive.
That's generally.
So tell us about what you did this morning before you came to the show.
Well, on the way to the show, we went paragliding. Holly just got her P2 rating, so she's free to just go fly and have a good time.
That's awesome. So you're going to get Dr. Lockhart up there, right?
I'd love to fly. That would be
we'll
so
throw
fun.
Her off.
We'll throw anybody off.
Now, what's this other picture, the fitness one?
I'm going to talk about that, Holly.
Oh, this is from the Ironman magazine shoot we actually did. It's kind of a funny story. Me and Mike went down to California just for fun. We went to Disneyland, and we stopped by this fitness expo, and they were having a competition there for the fittest couple. So I was like, I bugged Mike and told him, like, let's do it. It'll be so much fun. So they actually took our picture into a booth, and then we went to Disneyland, and they called us. Actually, what ride were we in?
It's a Small World.
It's a Small World, after all. Little song playing in the background, and
one of those really bumpy rides, right?
Yeah. And they say that we're actually finalists, so I was like, oh, that's cool. So we went back there, and we actually competed against other couples, and we took it. So we won first, and we won the shoot in Iron Man magazine.
That's awesome.
It was lots of fun.
So was that like your first competition?
Yeah, that was our first competition that we did.
That's amazing. Now, Mike, you recently just competed in your first competition. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well,
this is like your first individual, right?
Right. Since Holly did that other competition, that kind of spurred off her whole competition thing, and I was going to all the shows with her and training with her and going to all that, and she's like, Mike, you got to do this one, you know, I'm doing all the work, you might as well just get up on stage and do it. So just got up on stage and ended up winning. I won my heavyweight division. And
now, what is that? Is that, where was that at, that competition?
Oh, that was up in Boise, Idaho. It was the NGA Natural Body Northwest Regional Championships.
So how many states does that include?
There's people from California, Washington, Montana, Texas.
Wow.
There's people from everywhere.
And you won it?
Well. He took it.
That's amazing. Yeah. I mean, some of these guys have been probably training for 5, 10, 20 years, right?
Well, I've been training for 15 years.
But not competing.
Athletics. Basically, so it's all been athletic oriented. But
so, what's your back? Like, what kind of sports have you done?
You know, I got out of high school and played football up at Ricks College, and then I joined the Army and trained there for a while. And when I got out of the Army, I went to UVSC and ran track there. I did the 100 shot put and the 4x100 relay. Actually, went to nationals as the anchorman for the relay team.
That's awesome. Now, Holly, you're a track girl too, right?
Yep. I was. I got a lot of injuries in my senior year, my junior year. So
at college or high school?
No, it was in high school. So I was out for a little bit, and I've always kind of been to the gym and I've been going. But until I met Mike, I never really got into it, and he really taught me how to work out and exactly what to do, whole fitness.
So even though you've had serious injuries, mm-hmm. you can still work out no problem?
Yeah, definitely. I've broken my back. I've torn my hamstring. So I've had a lot of problems, but actually the working out actually helped me to heal better because I strengthened those muscles. So you baby it so much, it gets just weaker and weaker. That's what I was doing. Then he gets me out and goes, got to work it. I'm like, no. But he forced me, and it's a lot better now.
Now, what about our general viewing audience?
Uh-huh.
What do you recommend for people that haven't been athletic?
Yeah, just anything that you just do to get up and go. I mean, your body's meant to move to basically enjoy life. Go for a walk if you love walking, up in the mountains, go biking. Just take that time to like enjoy yourself and work out and have fun. Make it fun.
Well, that's one of the things that we want to do here on the show is we want to make, you know, we have some programs that we've worked up. Can you tell us just basically about those programs, Mike?
Well, we have five separate level programs, where the first level one is basically like no prior experience in the gym or no prior working out experience at all. And they got level two, which is, you know, you work out for a month or two, took a year off, worked out for a few more months, you know, a lot of people
in that category, right?
Exactly. And then you got level three, which people that are generally have been working out consistently and enjoy that and just good guidelines for there. And then level four, I'd probably be considered level four, pretty serious about it, but I'm not like a major competitive athlete anymore. And I think Holly would be like a level five or somebody like college athlete, high school athlete.
She won best of show, right?
She actually got best of show, so she's considered a pro. So
she got her pro card. I mean, that's amazing. We're talking, and you're only, how old are you?
I'm 21.
21, and she's a professional bodybuilder. It's amazing.
I love it. Just fitness industry is just so great.
One of the things, one of the reasons why we invited these guys to be our regular guests is you know, in this bodybuilding world, you know, drugs are a big part of it. In the athletic world, drugs are a big part of it. And one of the things that I admire about these guys the most is that they've never taken a drug. They took a polygraph at this last event. They took a polygraph test and a urine analysis because they were first in their category, and neither one of them tested positive. So they say between those two tests, it's 100% accuracy. These guys have never been on drugs. And it's just amazing to me that they can be this fit and look this good and not do what most of these other people are doing. What's motivating you?
Let me get this straight. They actually gave you a lie detector test?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What was that like? They strapped us in.
What did it look like?
What was it like?
They stick a sensor on your finger, you sit on a pad, put a thing around your chest and a headgear thing, and then they just sit there and ask you all kinds of questions, and it's just yes or no.
So it's that thorough. So,
yeah.
And the evidence was you've never taken any performance-enhancing drugs.
We haven't.
That is so great.
So that's not like just in baseball. I'm a baseball player, and you know they're testing for anabolic steroids, but there's also human growth hormone, and there's a myriad of other drugs that people are on.
Now, why is it that you were able to stay away from doing the drugs?
Probably my family, basically, and athletics is always a really big deal, but it was never worth messing up your body by taking all kinds of other stuff. And with having like a science background, you realize that hormones or anything else, any other chemicals, can really throw off your whole system, you know, and it's just better to stay natural. I mean, we can do everything by diet, really. If your diet's tuned, you don't need to do any kind of crazy stuff.
So people might look on you and just assume you've done drugs, but
Yeah.
But all my whole life,
you probably get that all the time, right?
My whole life is like people thought you're on stuff, and the people that are really close to me used to call me the Snapple Kid for 100% natural. But like everybody else would just speculate, I guess.
So what kind of things are you guys going to do during your fitness segment? Like during the show? What kind of things have you thought about? Some of the things
hoping Holly and I both really like to be outdoors and do things that are fun and natural and stuff. And
so it's not just in the gym stuff.
Yeah, it's practical stuff. I mean, you're not going to go to the gym and start bench pressing. You've never really been into the gym that much, but just stuff that you can go and do on your own, and you don't need to have the certain facilities and all that stuff. But
well, gyms can be intimidating. You know, if somebody's never
especially
been to
for
the
women,
gym.
I think that's one of the reasons, like Curse for Women, there's so many of them across the country, is because it's intimidating for a woman to walk in and see these big guys and
or little girls like this.
Yeah, the thing is, anyone can do it. I mean, you don't have to be like super fitness to like even go into a gym. I mean, anyone, just get out there and do it. Don't be afraid.
So you think it's important for like, I don't know, women in the 30 to 60s to lift weights or?
Definitely. Do lift weights for sure. I mean, your overall well-being will improve. I mean, your whole body is just so much better. You won't bulk up and get huge. Trust me, I know.
That's the biggest fear. So many women
think
they're going to look like this.
Yeah.
And it's impossible if you don't have the body type.
Yeah, see, with women aren't meant to. I mean, we don't have the genes to be like humongous, testosterone, veiny. So you're not going to get huge. You'll just become more fit. Overall well-being.
And also a major thing with lifting weights and resistance training is it really helps your bone density itself. So as women get into their...
So no osteoporosis?
Right. So as women get older and their body starts sapping calcium out of their bones and stuff, lifting weights actually helps their bones stay strong and dense.
So will you guys actually be demonstrating some things that they can do and make sure that they don't injure themselves? And
yep. We're going to be doing all that.
Cool.
Just for you guys.
And those could be, we'll demonstrate exercises you could do in your home. You don't have to go to a gym to do them.
You don't have to.
Maybe we can have some different guests on too. Mm-hmm. You know, different age groups.
Yeah.
So.
And we could have call-in people asking to demonstrate a certain exercise.
Cool.
There are all kinds of things we can do. What about personal training?
If like somebody wanted to hire you, Holly, how would they do it?
They would actually go on to gotgaga.com, Okay. And you can just leave a note there saying, you know, I'd like to hire this person. I mean, you can do online personal training.
And how much would that start at? Like, how much would that?
$15 a month.
$15 a month.
Very good price.
Everybody can afford that, right?
Yeah. Anyone can afford that.
If you, like, private hire some hire trainers, I mean, they're getting $75 to $100 an hour. I mean, they can come to your house and do all that stuff.
So the more personalized it gets, the more expensive it is.
Right. Yeah. I'm saying, you know, $100 an hour versus $15 for a month. You know what I mean?
Right.
You can even fit it to you. I mean, you don't have to do the online. You can also do off, you know, on the phone, or you can even meet. So you can choose your own.
This is going to be a wonderful segment.
It is. It's going to be awesome.
It'll be great.
So many people think of fitness and exercise as, drudgery and work, but you make it so much fun.
It is fun. We'll make it fun.
It has to be fun.
It has to be fun or you won't do it.
That's right.
Bottom line.
Well, we're excited to have these guys on as regular guests. We appreciate your time with, you guys coming on. And I'm sure there's some people out there that would love to hire you guys and have you guys be their trainers. So
we're here for you.
Cool. All right. Well, thank you very much. We appreciate it. And we'll be back with the next segment here in a few minutes. Thanks. Hello, we're back. Aren't those guys cute?
Aren't they darling? And I love that when he was describing the levels of fitness, and he said he was a 4, and then she was a 5, mm-hmm. and there was no hint of competitiveness. Or oftentimes men think if a woman's better than he is, it somehow detracts from him.
Right.
And I just love that they're a married couple, and they have so much fun doing this together.
Well, that's one of the things that one of the things that GAGA has, we have a talent agency. And I first went to a fitness show and I saw Holly and she's this amazing girl and I'm like, would you be interested in being one of our models, you know, one of our fitness models? And anyway, she came into the office and she brought Mike in. But before she came in, I said, so you're married? And she said, yeah. And I go, do you have like a good relationship with your spouse? Like, you know, does he support you and your mm-hmm. fitness? And she just went on and on about what a great relationship they have. And I just thought, you know, these are the kind of people that I want to associate with, you know.
And as they start to have a family, have children, if she's active, that mother, if the mother's active, physically active, and loves to be involved outside, as they talked about, and live an active lifestyle, that has such an impact for good on the children.
Right.
Well, and with both of them being active.
Being a personal trainer, because I've been a personal trainer for 20 plus years, and that's probably one of the hardest things you'll ever overcome are people's habits, the things that they've grown up with.
Uh-huh.
And so, you know, it's just really hard to overcome those things, you know, that they're ingrained in them from the time they're small. And that's why I'm so pro sports and pro movement and just, you know, getting out and moving your bodies and doing something.
And when you look at them at this age, they're what, early 20s? Mm. And if they can stay active and maintain, they won't have that kind of bulk throughout their whole lives, but if they can stay active, that's what really makes a difference. And so for someone who hasn't stayed active, it's possible to get in shape a lot faster than people think.
Right.
And there's so much more to it than just the fitness. Now we're going to talk about what, nutrition?
Nutrition.
Okay.
So we have Blanca on next. So we're excited to go to roll to our next tape that we filmed last week. This is Blanca Williams. She's an awesome gal. I'm sure you guys will fall in love with her. Welcome to our nutrition segment, and we're excited to have Blanca Williams. She's our healthy chef, and I'd just like to introduce Blanca a little bit. She's an attorney. She graduated top 5 from her law school in Europe. She came here and graduated from BYU, also in law. So she can practice law here, both here in the United States and in Europe. And I guess the school that she graduated was kind of the Harvard of Europe, so it's an amazing accomplishment. So a very smart girl here. And she's also the healthiest person that I know, and I know a lot of people because I've been in this industry for a long time. So anyway, that's the reason that I chose Blanca. So tell us a little bit about why I think that you're so healthy.
Well, thank you. That was a very nice introduction. Well, I think that because my choice of eating or choice of food, it's probably better than other people's. And I was kind of raised this way because my younger brother was diagnosed with tummy ulcers when he was 5 years old, and my mom kind of started to study and look at him, and she was cooking kind of healthy meals. And then as I left home, I was continuing by myself and educating myself and getting from vegan to raw food and continuing to learn and learn more.
And you're not raw anymore.
I'm not raw anymore. I stopped to eat raw like 2 weeks ago. I was raw for 2 years straight, but I stopped for my husband's support, and so now all my family eats together. But mainly, maybe 90% is still raw.
So tell us where you're from. You talked about your family. Where did you grow up? That kind of stuff.
I'm from Czechoslovakia, and I was raised there in a small town called Partizanske. I'm sure that nobody knows where it is. And then I went to law school to Greece, to Thessaloniki, and after when I graduated, I came to BYU for the law program, and I graduated in April. And
Dr. Lager was asking about your husband.
How did you two meet?
Well, I met my husband at the gym, and my husband and Tom are best friends.
So it's good to go to the gym, right?
Yeah, it's a good. If you want to marry, go to gym. And no, so
I've been going to gyms all my life.
Yeah, I know. It's
so you didn't get married?
Didn't work for me.
Well, keep going, keep trying. So it's a good place to go. And so my husband knows Tom for a long time, and so I met Tom through my husband.
So tell us about, you just got back from the Gerson Clinic, which is one of the most well-known in the world for, curing the incurable.
Yes.
I mean, that's kind of
what took you there?
Well, my husband and I applied for life insurance in November last year, and he was turned down because through the blood test they found out that his liver enzymes are very high. The normal range of the liver enzyme is between 30 to 45, and his one of the liver enzymes was 508, and so they wouldn't insure him. And
is this due to a parasite? Or?
Well, 20 years ago when he went for his church mission, he got hepatitis B. And after 1 month, he was sent back home from hospital, and the doctor told him that he's fine. The problem was that from his acute stage of hepatitis B, it became the chronic stage, and according to orthodox doctors, it's incurable.
So then you went to the doctors, and what did they tell you to do?
Well, we went to the specialist here in Salt Lake City, in liver doctor, and they did the liver biopsy. And so we were sitting at the doctor's office, and he was giving us all those prognoses and tell us that he might have maybe 2 years to live, and that he's...
Trent said 2 to 5, they gave you that range.
Yes, he wasn't sure how long because they don't really know. And so they were giving him three different medications which wouldn't cure him, just would kind of buy him time until he would get worse.
So it doesn't really... The medications don't really hit the cause of the disease. They
No.
just kind of mask the symptoms, or what are they?
Well, yeah. The thing was that Trent, my husband, he never experienced any symptoms, really. He just would get tired. That was the only thing. But everyone gets tired, so he wasn't really paying that much attention to it. But those medications would give him side effects, and he refused it. And then when we were sitting there, I just asked doctor if he needs to change a diet or he needs to eat or drink something special. So I wanted to know what he has to say, and he was like, oh no, don't worry about it, he's fine. He maybe can cut salt when he gets worse.
And you had seen nutrition actually help your brother.
Yes.
So you could see what an effect it has in
yes.
terms of positive health.
Yes.
That you don't always have to rely on medicine, but nutrition
yes.
can be a way
That's
of healing.
Right. That's why we try to find a natural way. And one of our friend told us about this clinic in Mexico. It's on the border of San Diego. So there is a program which was developed by Dr. Gerson, Max Gerson. He's a German doctor, and he suffered from migraines for so many years, and he realized that sometimes there's a certain things that he was eating and caused him headaches. So he kind of developed the nutrition plan for himself, and he cured his patient who suffered from migraines. And the other patient came to him as a cancer patient, and he was like, well, I don't cure cancer. But they still wanted to try and go on his nutritional program, and it worked. And during the 50 years, he just developed certain program for the cancer patient and people who have the terminal diseases that are uncurable. And it really works. And so we spent 2 weeks in Mexico, and my husband...
How expensive was that?
We paid for 1 week $5,500, and there was
For both of you?
For both of us. There's no additional cost for a companion, so just for patient, $5,500.
Now, that improvement occurred in just 2 weeks?
No, this was in... Trent had his, and I copied this off from Trent, but he had these taken from the doctor's office here in the United States, and then he had it taken after his experience there at Gerson 4 months later. And basically, his numbers... There's five different measurements, but some of his numbers, you know, are in the, you know, they started, one was 508, the other was 244, the other was 150, and those same measurements here are 47, 58, and 46.
Which is now in the normal range.
Which is now in the normal range. So basically, you know, this incurable disease has gone into remission again because of this...
Because of diet.
Because of nutrition.
So just to show how crucial... what we eat is.
It's
so, and you know that through your life experience now, not only your own growing up years with your family, but now with your husband.
Right.
What kinds of things will we do on the show that are possible? We're not going to all run to a clinic in Mexico, but what can we do on the show to help people to have a better nutritional program?
I think that...
Without going to extremes, just what would be better eating?
Mm-hmm. I think that when you talk to people and tell them, oh, you need to go on this diet or that diet, you know, that's going to work, I wouldn't really call it as a diet. I think that is the way to eat. And
see, that's what we talk about in our book. We say diet is a bad word in our book. We talk about healthy nutrition.
Yeah.
You know, so we're trying to feed the body. You know, it's like the body can cure anything. It's not the drugs, or it's not the, you know, the natural medicine, or it's not this or that that's curing it. It's the body that's curing the disease once you feed it the proper nutrients.
And so what we're trying to enhance is our good choices, positive eating, not starving yourself.
No,
not dieting, if you will, where you're depriving yourself, but rather providing your natural healing system, which your body has, with the proper fuels.
Yes, I would like to share with people the way how I eat and the way how I gradually became the way how I am right now. And there are many, many good recipes that can be made with natural things and doesn't need to be a necessary process. And I think that we can really enjoy food that is healthy.
So can you tell us about some, like, I hear about these recipes, like these people that, like, you're famous in your neighborhood for some recipes. What are you concocting over there? What are you brewing up?
Well, one time we were invited for the war activities, and I was assigned to make a dessert. And so I made the cheesecake, which was raw cheesecake. It wasn't cooked.
And what did you make it out of?
I made it from the walnuts and dates, and the filling was made from cashew and honey and lemon juice.
I'm drooling.
And so I made this dessert, and so we came to that party or whatever, and so there was a one big table with desserts, and of course mine was gone first. So, and people were
asking... Out of all the junk, yours goes first and it's
goes first, and people were really, you know, excited about it. They thought that this kind of ice cream and what kind of cheese that's right.
And then online, there's so many, how many thousands of recipes?
Yeah, we have.
Do you have on the website?
Yeah, thousands, yeah. Literally thousands of recipes.
I have a really good recipe for ice cream, but I left it for next time.
All right.
I will leave it next time.
So anyway, we appreciate Blanca. Again, I think she's the healthiest person that I know as far as her nutritional habits. We're excited to have her on your show, and we're going to try to rig up a little bit of a place where you can do some cooking.
Great. So we're not just going to talk about this.
Right. We're not going to talk about it. We're going to actually do it and taste it. Good. So anyway, thank you, Blanca.
Well, thank you for having me.
Excited to have you.
Thank you.
So we appreciate your time during the segment, and we'll be right back. Thank you. Isn't she a cutie?
She's darling. I can't wait to try some of these recipes that she's told us about.
Yeah, she'll actually be here later today, so you'll have
your chance to taste
of this. The ice cream. She's bringing ice cream, and she's bringing her pie, and you're going to have a feast.
Well, you haven't tasted my pie yet.
We're going to have your pie on here.
Yeah, we got to have my pie.
No, we wanted to let you know that, you know, both of us, you know, Blanca does, you know, she doesn't eat meat. She's most of her diet is raw, but we don't promote that on the show. We think it's a healthy way to eat. And, you know, and a lot of times when we were just talking about it in between the segment, a lot of people, when they think raw, you know, they think, oh, you know, these weird dishes, but it's like raw carrots and raw, you know, fruit, and all those things are raw. So, you know, without the cooking, the more that we can add those things in, probably the healthier that our diet's going to be. What do you think?
I think, and again, we're going to come back to the healthy principles. What are the principles behind eating well? And probably the worst word for us is diet, because all you're doing then is depriving yourself of good food. So we're interested not in dieting per se, but again, choosing well, making wise choices. There's good food out there, and again, it's fun. It's not a drudgery to eat well.
Right, and that's why we get excited about Blanca's, because she gets kind of, like I said, she's kind of famous in her neighborhood for some of these dishes that people will go to instead of the sugary stuff that people normally go to. And that's why we're excited to have her on, because she's learned to create things that are really healthy but are really tasty at the same time.
Sounds good to me.
So anyway, now we're going to hit off to Karen, who's going to do our mind and spirit segment. So we're excited to have Karen on. We think that you'll really enjoy her. So here we go. Welcome to Nurturing Your Spirit segment. We're excited to have Karen Grant here. She's going to be our regular guest on the show. And Karen, tell
excited
us about
to
you.
Be here. My favorite thing is to be able to nurture the spirit of the human soul, and I'm excited to be able to share that with many ones.
Karen, how did you get into this?
I started at age 15. I was writing music, and so I every day took time out for myself and did a connection with my spirit, listening, writing poetry, writing music, and that's when I started.
That is so great. And you're a singer?
Mm-hmm. Started writing music at 15. Writing songs.
So tell us about all this stuff down here. It's got these amazing CDs. Tell us about these.
When I was 15, I dedicated my little guitar to writing songs for the Savior. And I promised him that I would only write songs for him. And I have now produced over 30 CDs of music for the Spirit to integrate heart and mind and body. And then later, when I went to massage school, I started studying aromatherapy, and every song has an oil. So for instance,
so you have 30 oils?
Well, there's many songs on a CD, so I've got 200 oils. And so like this is the healer's touch.
Uh-huh.
And this is for clearing emotional wounds, helping to heal the broken heart. And there's 9 songs, 9 instrumentals, and 9 oils. So they're little sets.
Cool.
And so there's a song called Magic Kisses, and there's a oil called Magic Kisses, and there's a song called Childlike Faith, and there's an oil called Childlike Faith. And this one happens to be Breathe Ease, which is for respiratory coughs and So they address all different areas.
What are in the oils? I've heard so much about oils and, you know, the positive effects. What are
essential
they?
Oils are basically the lifeblood of the human plant, and they have one little chemical link different than human blood. So if you rip a geranium leaf, you'll see that cut begin to heal itself. And just like human blood heals a wound, we heal in much the same way. And the plants work the same way. They have a pure intelligence, and they're right on their mission. They're right on course. They don't deviate from their original personality. And you put them together in blends, and they are not only beautiful, but they're healing emotionally, spiritually, and physically.
One of the things that has amazed me that kind of got me so excited about oils is I've tried so many different things for like sore throats and congestion. And I was dating a gal and she had the essential oils and she gave me essential oil for I had like a sore throat where I could barely swallow. She had me drink a few drops and then she put some on the bottom of my feet and then on my throat, and within a couple minutes it went away. And I'm just like,
it's amazing.
This is amazing. I've never experienced anything like that.
Now, do you make your own oils or do you?
I have an aromatherapist who created all the blends, and I just gave them the intentions.
So there's a real science behind this.
There is. There's a real science. I use kinesiology. You shouldn't put oils on your body that you don't need. So I'll do muscle testing with each client and make sure that they're needing the particular oil before I use it on them.
So tell us about your exactly what you're trained in and what you do.
Okay. Well, I do music as therapy. Basically, it's using all five senses to heal the human spirit and to reach into the hidden wounds of the heart, the wounds that nobody else can see. And you become very intuitive when you start doing this work. My goal is with each client that they become more whole and more intuitive with themselves, and then they reach out and bless their children, their husbands. And
so you might have somebody who's gone through a divorce or someone who's lost.
I work with depressed, sexually abused. And I have many male clients and female and some children. My goal is to help the mothers to do the work so that they can do their own husbands and their own children.
So you would teach them massage or teach them?
I teach classes in aroma, music, massage. I've done that for 5 years. It's really fun. Every Friday, classes in that.
So I would think, like, probably our main viewing audience is women 30 to maybe 60 years old.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the major issues that that age group is dealing with?
Well, stress being number one. Women are the
stress
caretakers, the nurturers, and now the providers in many cases, a lot of single women.
So
and we're running faster than we're able, and we're running on sheer adrenaline a lot of the time. So we need to slow down and create a time for self-nurturing. I use the bath time now. And that is 20 minutes a day. I do an aromatic bath with salts and salt scrubs.
So it would be erroneous to think you have to take 2 or 3 hours out of your day.
We don't have time to take 2 or 3 hours. And it's amazing, you get faster and faster at connecting to your spirit as you do this.
Now, I went through this. I felt like I had like Karen was working on me, and then I had somebody else working on me. I felt like I got up, and I'm like, I feel like I'm a king. I'm just like...
It's wonderful.
I never felt so, like, good afterwards, or like I was... I mean, maybe it's because I'm not married or whatever, but I've never felt that before.
I
felt like a king, seriously.
It's very nurturing. It's we don't have enough physical human touch, therapeutic touch. And with the scare of sexual abuse, we've all backed off and we're afraid to touch each other, afraid to give hugs. And so this is just bringing it into a very positive area with boundaries, teaching moms and dads to do it. I have fathers that are my clients that are now doing massage for their children. It's great.
So can we do something online for people? I mean, is there a way that you could help people teach some of these techniques online?
I can't. It's hard to teach massage over the phone, but I can do emotional clearing over the phone. And with kinesiology, it's very intuitive. And with kinesiology, people can call and ask questions. And
so would they just go to our website and then just ask for you?
Yeah.
Now, you talked about emotional clearing. Could you describe that a little more?
Well, I started out, I had suffered with depression. And so I felt like, I just noticed that when I sang, I felt better. And when I wrote music, I felt better. And so I started incorporating my music all about the heart onto CDs and sharing that with clients and people throughout the past 15 years. And then the emotional clearing kind of geared off from that. They would be on the table experiencing the music and the oils, and the clearing just started happening. So there was actually no professional training in the beginning for emotional clearing per se, but it became very intuitive. Mm-hmm. And tears would come up during their massages, and we would go through with what I prefer to call what I do heart-mind integration, which is addressing the feeling, the emotion that's blocked, whether it be fear or doubt, and clearing that out through breath work, through music, through the oils. The oils go right into the amygdala, two almond-shaped places in the brain, and start to clear emotions that have been trapped even since childhood.
People don't realize how physical emotions can be. That may sound very odd, but one of the reasons for our show is for people to learn that the body, mind, and spirit are all interconnected.
They're so connected, and if we are not emotionally balanced, then it will lodge in the body. Those emotions are molecules in motion, and they get stuck in the liver, or we carry resentment in our liver, we carry fear, we carry anxiety in our lungs, grief that we've never fully verbalized or expressed. And it's amazing how people can come in and feel comfortable with someone that they don't know and be able to clear those, get up off the table, feel like I've just been to 30 sessions of regular psychotherapy, and it's just using those senses.
So what do you have planned for these? Because you're going to be a regular mm-hmm. guest with us. We're excited to have you. What are you going to be doing?
How about a little massage?
I would love to set up a massage table and demonstrate some cranial sacral, the cranial unwinding, which is dance, and I was so excited when I read about your history with dance. A lot of people are paralyzed. They're in a physical body, but they're imprisoned. Mm-hmm. And I know I was. I had a lot of depression and fear of movement because I was a chubby child.
And can you tell us a little bit about that whole experience?
Being overweight as a child, yeah, I didn't feel like chubby girls dance, so I didn't dance. And I had a dancing spirit and a dancing heart, but didn't feel comfortable doing that. And released that and
so
started
did
out
with... So did you struggle with your weight?
All my life, it's been up and down. And
so how did you overcome that?
I read Harvey and Marilyn Diamond's book, Fit for Life, and really connected to live food and raw food and enzymes, but still that did not take away my craving for chocolate, and I am a sugar-aholic, and it runs in my family. And so basically my husband gave me a gastric bypass, and that was one of the hardest things on my digestive system. So now I am forced to eat differently.
So how much weight have you lost?
115 pounds.
Wow. That's amazing.
I got up to 245 pounds.
That's amazing.
And people will come in and say, you can't possibly understand me because I weigh 200.
Can.
And I say, oh, yeah, I can understand. I've been every weight in the book, and I have every size of clothes hanging in my closet. So
is understand. It easy for you now to maintain that weight?
Out of force, it is. Oh, yeah, I don't have to try. That was the one nice thing about a gastric bypass is that you don't really have to try anymore. But you do have to be very careful about.
Now, a lot of people that they have that surgery, but they gain all the weight back. How did you keep it down?
I did not drink soft drinks. Soft drinks balloon the stomach and stretch it out. And I think I've been blessed to not be able to gain the weight back.
Now, Barbara, you had a couple comments about, you know, feelings of self. Well, I mean, you don't call it self-worth, but you call it worth. Do you want to maybe mention that a little bit?
Well, it's what you're talking about, the spiritual dimension. And I'm so excited because when you think of healthy living, oftentimes people just leave that out. They think diet, they think nutrition, they think exercise. But a key...
They forget their creator.
Well, and the key mm-hmm. is your spirit and your attitudes toward yourself and So when you understand the worth of your whole soul, your body and your spirit, then it connects exactly with what you're saying.
And it's interesting to me because for me, I had to connect to my spirit first. I didn't feel at home in my body. I didn't even feel at home on the planet. I felt homesick for pure love. And
so some people they're going to want to start with you and then maybe
move. And then they'll move and they'll start getting excited and joyful about life and want to add on after they indulge themselves in enough rest and relaxation, they'll be ready to do the recreation and then they'll move on to the exercise. So
I think different people start different places.
For sure. Yeah. Definitely. But that dimension is a part of everyone, every soul.
It is.
It's just often undiscovered.
Well, that's one of the reasons I love taking, she was my favorite professor at BYU, and it's just because she integrated that spirit into the physical education, and that's what I love so much about Dr. Lockhart's classes.
And
so that's why she's here.
I appreciate that about what he's told me about you, because I had PE teachers that if you weren't the best,
athlete,
and you were kind of left in the shuffle, and you didn't dare try, because you didn't want to look uncoordinated, you know, so.
Well, we're excited to have Karen on as our regular guest. I'm sure you guys are too. And she's got some great things planned. She's a ball of energy. Every time I talk to her, she's like,
"Get excited about
life
all this.
Is fun."
Do it now, Karen. Do we get
it's
to hear you
fun.
Sing?
I would love to sing for you.
Oh, that would be great.
Yeah.
So, anyway, we appreciate you tuning in, and we'll be back in a minute. Barbara's teasing me because I'm saying you guys. I don't mean you guys. I mean everyone out there. You guys, you gals, you kids.
There you go.
Older people, whoever, younger people. So we're excited to be with the show, and we think that you're going to have a great time with us. Every show, we're going to try to kind of how we approach our life. And again, I've learned a lot of this from Dr. Lockhart. Is you know we approach it in a body, mind, spirit way. And so, you know, we're trying to take that same approach with the show.
Well, we can talk about the body and the mind and the spirit and deal with those as individual components. But the way we live, it's this total, wonderful, integrated self. And that's what we'll emphasize on the show.
Right.
This is going to be so fun.
It is. It's going to be exciting.
Great.
And, you know, if you guys have any comments, you guys and you gals, if you have any comments about how to make our show better or maybe some really good regular guests for us, we welcome your input. And, you know, the same thing on our book, you know, it's like I say over and over, it's like with each edition, I want to make it a little bit better. And so, you know, the idea is that over time that this book will improve. And our hope with the show is also that over time it will improve. One of the things, we do have a live appearance coming up. We're teaming up here in American Fork on starting next Saturday. We're doing it's kind of a date night for a husband and wife. I think it's like $30 or $40. But if you guys are interested in coming to that, you can just go to our website, www.gotgaga.com, or you can email me, Tom, at gagainternational.com if you have any comments about the show or you'd like to attend the conference. Actually, Karen, Dr. Lockhart, and myself will be actually speaking live at this. At these, it's from 7 to 9 at the Quality Inn in American Fork. So, anyway, that's going to be fun. We're going to get to do a live show or a live presentation. So, anyway, we appreciate you guys tuning in. We're going to have some great guests in our future. We're lining those up right now. If you're interested in purchasing our book, you can go to our website. It's there on our website, and we'll drop ship it to your doorstep. And we thank you. We appreciate you. And this show is for you. So do you have any closing comments?
Well, maybe just to say we hope that you'll be with us every Friday at 11 o'clock. We'll be here on Channel 20.